In this video, we take a look at the top 5 features coming your way in SAP Analytics Cloud. These include Just Ask Next Generation Language Query powered by AI, Flexible Model, New Model Disaggregation based on another measure, Event Synchronization with Microsoft Office Calendar 365, and Data Analyzer New Formula Editor. Hi, my name is Orla Cullen, and these are your What's New updates for QRC 1 2024. First up, I'm very excited to introduce Just Ask, our next generation natural language query powered by AI. Users can now access Just Ask directly from the SAP Analytics Cloud homepage to query acquired data models and SAP Datasphere models. Questions can be asked from the top menu or the home screen. We start by asking, what is the total contract value today? This question illustrates Just Ask's understanding of time. By saying today, a query filter on today's date is created. Similarly, requests such as last week, last month, or even this year can also be used. The question also highlights the use of synonyms. Total contract value is actually not part of the data model. It's a synonym for order value, which is a measure on our data model. Just Ask also automatically infers the words with similar meanings based on word embeddings and also supports synonyms for dimension members. For example, if we ask how many units were sold in LATAM, it knows that this is a synonym for South America. Suggestions is another feature to help users express their questions. Type-ahead suggestions are immediately available when typing, and users can select a suggestion from the drop-down or use autocomplete. For example, we can ask, what is the impact of client visits on travel expenses? On the right hand, we also have suggested questions. These are based on previous questions asked. Notice that the scatter plot displays a data point per sales agent, even though there is no mention of sales agent in the question. This is based on a rule, and we'll see that in a minute. Taking a look behind the curtain, here we see how models are managed by Just Ask. Here is our model, and we can see the synonyms which we've already used earlier, for example, total contract value. For sales agents, various synonyms are also defined. And if we look a little closer, we can see the rules that we had alluded to earlier. The rule conditions are based on the question asked. And in this case, if the question includes client visits and travel expenses, then the action is to add the sales agent dimension, which is what we saw on our scatter plot earlier. Our modeling capabilities have evolved a lot in the last few years, and in this quarter, we bring together some big changes that will bring increased flexibility and enormous value to our customers. These include the ability to create new models with data uploads, the ability to transform data in the fact table, and dimensions without master data. One of the major features of the new 2024 QRC 1 release is the ability to create new models directly from data. Previously, this could only be done with the account model or dataset. When the data is finished loading, we are brought directly to the modeler. We are landing in the list view, and down below we can see a data foundation that's already full because we're pulling data from a data source. A couple of interesting features to point out here is that firstly, if you look down below in the dimension space, all dimensions are what's known as single column dimensions. Just like in the dataset, they do not yet have a dimension table assigned to them. You can turn them into proper managed dimensions with proper managed master data, or you can leave them as a dataset style single column dimension. One of the major advantages is also the ability to go back and edit the wrangling along with the modeling. Previously in the classic account model, you could edit the wrangling one time and then you could only edit modeling after that. Staying on modeling, in this quarter, we introduce a new disaggregation setting on the measure dimension. So now in addition to the standard disaggregation, you can alternatively configure a measure to disaggregate based on the weightings of another measure. This can simplify scenarios where perhaps I want to disaggregate costs or sales based on a quantity measure and then ensure that disaggregation logic and the relationship is enforced across the solution. Let's take a look. Here I am in my modeler. And if I take a given measure, you'll see that I have the ability to change the disaggregation type property to reference another measure. In this case, I'm looking at the sales target measure. I've changed the reference measure to be quantity and the disaggregation mode to be total disaggregation. Going back to my story, I enter a target for January. Let's assume 40,000 for simplicity. And then because I have total disaggregation set, you'll see that I have an equivalent number of sales to the quantity. Next, we'll key in some targets for February. Let's assume this time 100,000 for each category of bikes. And then we'll change the total to 600,000. What I see here is my original entry will get wiped and it will be disaggregated based on the weightings of the quantity. So this is how disaggregation works. It will eliminate whatever existed previously, and this disaggregation method will apply regardless of where I enter the data. Jumping back to the modeler, and this time we'll change the disaggregation mode from total distribution to delta distribution, and we save the model. Going back to my story, and we're back to the scenario where we have 100,000 per bike. Now, if I change the total in this case to 500,000, what ends up happening is 100,000, that differential is spread to the individual bikes based on the weighting of the quantity. So this is how the delta distribution is handled. An exciting new feature this quarter is the ability to integrate calendar tasks with the Microsoft Office and Teams calendars. So now an event owner can enable this integration, and then any changes that they make to the task will be reflected in the local calendars of the event participants, whether they're assignees or reviewers. Let's look at the SAP Analytics Cloud calendar and Microsoft Office 365 side by side. First, we open the event settings and enable the integration. This leads to a pop-up page where we have to log into our Microsoft Office 365 account. This leads to mirroring, synchronizing all events of the calendar in SAP Analytics Cloud into the calendar of Microsoft Office. Here we have the calendar of a planner who's responsible for the sales target of a particular product. In their calendar, they can open the event and they can see here the SAP Analytics Cloud notifications. We can also navigate directly to the planning dashboard to maintain the sales targets for the upcoming period. By adding 7 million to the overall budget, we can then submit our new plan. Data Analyzer continues to go from strength to strength with the new Formula Editor. The new Formula Editor has an improved user experience, enabling the user to create new calculations. To open the new Formula Editor, we open the Builder panel and select Add Calculation. The editor can also be moved or resized. Up the top, we have two input fields, description and ID, which allows us to create multiple calculations with the same description. The side panel shows the list of available measures, support functions, operators, and conditions. If I select any of the functions, I'm also given a description in the help section below. Simply double-clicking adds my function to the formula editor. The side editor can also be collapsed, and using Ctrl+C, we get a list of functions and measures in the drop-down menu. Let's create a simple calculation. I want to create a percentage share of sales volume. I give it a name and I save it, and I immediately see my new calculated measure in my table. Thank you for joining us to learn about some of the top features coming in the Q1 2024 release cycle of SAP Analytics Cloud. Check out the video description for more links to resources about this quarter's update. Also remember to leave a like on this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with all things SAP Analytics Cloud. Thanks again, and see you next time.